Hey everyone, welcome to a lovely, hot, scorching sunny day, hence why I'm standing in the shade at the moment. We're going to be doing a bit of a shooting test today. This is the KJW KC02, replica of the 1022 rifle by Ruger. For those of you who saw the unboxing video, I just did that yesterday. You've probably noticed outside it has changed a bit, but internally it's all exactly stock. So the way this shoots now is the way yours will shoot if you pick one up. Magazine wise, using the standard mags with some 0.25 gram BBs, filled up with propane. And what we're going to be doing is we've got a target set up about 20 meters away, and we'll be taking a few shots at that, putting out a magazine towards that. Have a look at that now. As you can see, we're shooting just from here onto that target. It's about a foot wide, I'd say. As I say, I measured it to about 20 meters. The weapon, we're on propane, it'll be shooting about 450 FPS with the 0.25s. You could probably use a heavier BB at that FPS, probably more like a 0.3. This is just what I've got today. I think at this range should be alright. So I've had a quick fire this beforehand. I've done my best to set the hop and sort of the scope a little bit. It's not perfect, but it's not too bad. Something to bear in mind with the test: the actual inner barrel on this, the starter's, as I say, it's still a stock one, and it's only a 6.08 in terms of the internal diameter, and it actually only runs to about there. All of this part of the outer barrel, nothing in there. The inner barrel, the hop up unit, about here, inner barrel runs to about that, which is very short inner barrel. So just something to bear in mind, and that's about the length of the CQB M4, and M4 with about a 10.5 inch barrel. So I'll say bear that in mind when it comes to the accuracy of the results. So get on with the shooting. Okay, so we're down in position now. Just can get set up. Shooting the target, I meant shooting at the target I mentioned just before. Let's see what we can do. One mag. Bit of a double feed, sort of a jam at one point there, but not bad. One or two flyers left and right, but as soon as the hop unit's brand new,
given how hot it is today, it's not the ideal shooting conditions. So let's see what we've done to the target. Okay, so looking at the target, overall, the majority of the group is about, well, the majority of it is about that wide. You've got a few flyers, one up there, and a bit out of there, but considering the length of that inner barrel, that's really not bad at all. The majority of shots all in there. There were one or two, I mean, you wouldn't have seen it, but me looking through the scope, I saw one or two fly off left and right around the time I got that sort of stoppage there. Not sure what happened there, bit of an issue, but overall, if you consider that is about the size, it's about the size of someone's head, and this is at 20 metres, so that's just using 0.25 BBs when you know, probably threes would be more ideal. Very hot weather, so I think that's actually not too bad at all for a stock type, a stock barrel that's not a type bore and very short. I'm not that well practiced myself, and very windy. It is a windy day. There was a few gusts that picked up during that, so yeah, fairly happy with that. That's it. Let's see what we can do with some fruit. As you can see here, we've got three pretty normal common or garden cherries. It's lined up along this raised bed. They're pretty tiny targets, so I'm not going to be shooting from far away, but this thing does kick out a fair old FPS. So, let's see what happens.
Wasps are going to be all on them.
So, yes, as you can see, that's pretty much made a nice red mist out of those. Cheers for watching, guys. See you next time.